Low-res Wonderland.
So, I mean, looking back at your film career, do you find yourself thinking about all of your different characters? I mean, do you...
Sure, from time to time. And I always say it's good once in a while to go back and look at earlier work, because it might give a kind of a something for the work you're doing now.
David Lynch has had a sordid history with Hollywood. But that's to be expected from any auteur that defies the norm.
Hello, everybody. Today, I'm going to put these panties in my mouth.
However, the major studios lack of enchantment with David Lynch, and his checkered track record with the box office has, over the years, resulted in some of his projects falling to the wayside. But just because certain ideas had been scrapped, that did not mean they'd been forgotten. Lynch, like many filmmakers, has been known to recycle concepts from unmade projects and funnel them into whatever contemporary plans are on the docket. While Ronnie Rocket may be David Lynch's most famous unmade film, the one that resonates most with his 2017 work happens to be a screenplay co-written with his fellow Twin Peaks creator Mark Frost called One Saliva Bubble. One Saliva Bubble was intended to be a slapstick comedy starring Steve Martin and Martin Short and released sometime around 1988 or 1989 following Blue Velvet's success. The central plot of the film was that, due to a secret government experiment gone awry, many of the citizens of Newtonville, Kentucky have undergone a dramatic shift in personality. As a matter of fact, each of their bodies gained new ones that belong to other people. And how exactly does that happen? A random security guard's saliva bubble exits his mouth and floats into the circuitry of the said top secret government project. Yeah, that sounds pretty David Lynch to me. This plot should not be a shocker, no pun intended, to any fans of Lynch, as the general idea seems to be a recurring theme in many, if not most, of his films. Someone is not who they claim to be, or who they think they are, or the person that others believe them to be. One Saliva Bubble is not only no different, but it's arguably Lynch's ground zero for this particular motif. The consciousness of some of Newtonville's inhabitants are residing in bodies that are not of their original ownership. This concept is mostly explored in Lynch's later works, most notably Twin Peaks and Mulholland Drive, and in One Saliva Bubble, the tone is far different on the whole from what we're used to seeing from David. It leans into the goofier elements of Lynch and is fully intended to be comedic.
Let's fuck!
Had Dougie not come along in the most recent season of Twin Peaks, we probably wouldn't have been able to find an apt comparison to the characters in this script. Granted, Leland Palmer is in the same general ballpark, but that character had some major uncomfortable issues beneath this smiley dancing veneer that wouldn't have exactly blended with those found in One Saliva Bubble. Because David Lynch wrote the script with Mark Frost, One Saliva Bubble is quite reminiscent of the early Twin Peaks seasons, to the point of reading like a close relative of the series, a blood cousin, perhaps. It isn't difficult to imagine characters like Andy or Lucy venturing into Newtonville and being stitched in seamlessly. That may be a result of the wacky dialogue and humor, which on paper don't necessarily read as funny or witty unless you take your comedic cues from David Spade movies, but the script has the key markings of Lynch all the same. Unfortunately, it wasn't long before Lynch lost interest in the project, and due to behind-the-scenes difficulties, the studio wound up scrapping it. 3 years later, both David Lynch and Mark Frost moved on to a new project, North Dakota. North Dakota was focused around small-town life and its inhabitants, and that eventually evolved into what was pitched to ABC as Northwest Passage. That came into fruition as Twin Peaks. Next time, I'll be delving into the contents of the script and its characters and the story of One Saliva Bubble. Thanks for tuning into this video. If you dug it, or if my opinions pissed you off, give a thumbs up, give a thumbs down, or let me know in the comments section. And keep up to date on everything Low-res by following us on Facebook and Twitter. Another thing to keep in mind, patrons get exclusive videos and behind the scenes information, so consider tossing us a buck or two if you're in the mood for more of that sweet, delicious, highly charged content that you could only find on scrambled television sets not long ago. Also, if you're not in the mood to type those links out, I don't blame you, it happens, your fingers get cramped, whatever. Check out the description below this video, they're all listed there for your clicking pleasure.